Hello, this is Marco Melandri.
Sylvain Guincholi.
I'm Tom Sykes.
I'm Jonathan Ray.
I'm Leon Camier.
I'm Leon Haslam.
And you're watching Motorcyclenews.com.
Welcome to MCN, and this is a 2012 Suzuki GSX-R 600. Now this is our favourite 600 at the moment with MCN. 600s are massive fun. They're relatively cheap to buy and insure, and they've got all the bits on them, but 600s now, the sales of new bikes are going down, and it seems like a lot of the manufacturers have almost given up on them as well. So what are the new 600s? What bikes tick the boxes like a 600 used to? So if you were the kind of person that were turned on by a 600, but you don't actually want to buy a 600, we reckon these bikes here are a good alternative. We've got the Ducati Street Fighter 848, the Triumph Street Triple R, the Suzuki GSX 650F, and the Aprilia Tuono. Now, will these bikes scratch your itch like a 600? Well, we're going to find out. But before our verdict, I just want to explode a few myths about 600s. The perception is they're really revvy and they're pretty impractical and uncomfortable. Well, they do rev. To get the best out of them, you've got to thrash them, but they're pretty tractable as well. This GSX-R outgrunts a 999 and a Daytona 675, which is pretty impressive. It's roomy. This has got adjustable pegs as well, so I can give myself more leg room if I want. It's comfortable, there's a tall screen, and you know, I'd be happy taking this tour in as I would do on a track day. So if you are after 600, don't be put off by those little things that you might hear people say that they're impractical, because they're not. You might notice three chaps behind me who have brought along to do our test with us. They're MCN readers and they're Supersport 600 owners. There's Kyle, Jason and Simon. They've all got modern day 600s, so this test is aimed at them really. Now, they've ridden all the bikes, as have I, all day, and the conclusion is that two of them would still go for a 600. There's nothing quite like the intensity of a 600 when on a good day, and like I said before, they're still practical and they're still fun. But one of them would go for the Street Fighter. A bit more involving, you've got much more comfortable riding position, so you know, this is a viable alternative to a 600. And their second choice, this bike, for all of them, is the Triumph Street Triple R, which we kind of thought it would be. It's got the bling, it's got radial brakes, fully adjustable suspension, it's really involving to ride, it's revvy, and you don't have to pay for that with a cramped riding position. For most of the time on the road, nice upright riding position is actually better. Now, the Tuono didn't really float our boats if you like a 600, because it's not involving enough. It's almost got too much power and too much in reserve for the road. And then the GSX 650, which is kind of typical of the breed of soft 600s, it's got a full fairing, it is fast, it brakes well, it handles well, but the performance just is too far off to really scratch your itch like a 600. So it's been a great day. The GSX-R still wins, but these two babies are our second choices.